Don't touch my hair. When it's the feelings I wear. Don't touch my soul. When it's the rhythm I know. Don't touch my crown. They see the vision I've found. Don't touch what's there.
Hello out there in YouTube land. I am back with another video, and today's video is to show you not this complete unit, but the hair that's actually on the unit. This is the 26 inch Indian deep wave from Yvonne's hair on AliExpress. The reason why I'm posting this video is because I think there's like only one other person that has like a deep wave review on the Yvonne's hair, like one or two people. So I purchased this hair, and even that's still really full. All of these short layers in the hair are actually the frontal. I don't know if you can kind of tell from backside. Really where the hair from the unit meets to where the bundles meet, it's a really, really, really good match. The curls are gorgeous, and this is actually what I thought the hair would be most like with the Malaysian curly from Yvonne's hair. I thought it would be these curls. Now, it's very similar, but the really big difference is that it's actually really loose at the root area. Probably 13 inches of the hair is actually like an actual wave, like a deep wave. And then the end, what I love about Yvonne's hair is they really know how to give you a gorgeous curl. A gorgeous, 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 gorgeous curl on the ends of the hair. And when it's wet, it's like little ringlets. It's really gorgeous. The hair is really soft. There's not a whole lot of matting or tangling. But my one con with this hair is that where it actually starts to become curly, it's thin. This is all the hair pulled to the front. This is only, I would say, two bundles. Because I took out a bundle and kind of deconstructed it. And a lot of the hair on it was, on the actual weft of that bundle, was about 6 inches. So up here is really, really dense and full. And on the ends, it's quite thin. As you can see, it's really wavy and thick and dense at the top. And then once you get to the end, it's really, really thin. And as some of you know, like, I don't play when it comes to density. You want it to be thick from the weft all the way down. But if you're gonna give me 26 inches, I don't care if it's a less weight or something, but just make sure all of the hair is actually 26 inches. Don't give me, you know, three pieces of 26 inch hair and the rest of it is 8 inches. So I think I'm actually going to be cutting this hair. As you can see, as I'm playing with it, it is getting bigger and it's gonna grow. When it's in its most defined state, it's quite thin and you can see the difference. So I think I'm gonna cut it to a shorter length. Like I said, this is 26 inches. It may not look like 26 inches. I am 6'2", but this hair is 26 inches. It's very long, very strong, very gorgeous hair, but it's just not the thickness that I need it to be. Like, it's just not that thick at all. If you can, the thickness pretty much like stops right there, and then gorgeous curls. And that's where my hang up is that the curls are so gorgeous, but it's thin and I want it to be all one dense, thick unit. So I don't know. That is pretty much it. I just wanted to show you kind of like how the hair originally looks before I do any alterations to it. Really gorgeous. Not a lot of shedding, not a lot of tangling. My only hang up is like literally it's thick halfway into the bundle, and that's my only problem with this hair. It's gorgeous, gorgeous hair. And that's why I couldn't put in that's why I had to actually take out one of the three bundles that I used, because it was just way too dense in the top portion of the hair and too thin at the bottom. I just don't like that look. I'd rather have cut the hair into a bob, and that's what I've done with a lot of hair I've purchased, is I've had to cut it into a bob because it's only thick as a bob. It's not thick when you get into those longer lengths from certain companies. So that's what I've had to do. Alrighty, you guys, I just came back with a little bit of a switch up on the hair. This is still the Yvonne's Deep Wave hair. It's almost kind of got like a yakky texture to it when you straighten it out a little bit. But I was inspired, really just randomly inspired by SZA. Because she has really big curly hair. I've been to a concert of hers in person, and it's just really big and voluminous hair, and I was like, well, maybe I can do that with this hair. And I tried it and it worked out. I just used my 1-inch Babyliss Pro curling iron, and I just I didn't necessarily blow dry it. I just kind of brushed it out, and then I straightened it on the brushed out hair. Really quickly, really messy. But this is a really pretty look. If somebody like wants that just really dramatic, voluminous hair, I think this would be a really good choice. I still can tell the difference between the, you know, as far as density, but I mean, it's really gorgeous. I'm wondering if I should just keep this hair straight or straighten it even more and just keep it a straight unit instead of cutting it. I might do that. So I might just blow it out or straighten it out a little bit more and just keep it a straight unit. Maybe put some more layers in or like a bang or something. I don't know. But whatever. So this is the unit. If you guys have any other questions, comments, concerns, just leave it in the comment section and I'll get back to you as soon as possible. Peace. Up and separate, party favors for you.